Now I've got more vinyl space, I raided the loft and hit my mum's and stepdad's old vinyl collections. Hoi hoi everybody and welcome to this video. So yes, up in the loft was, or is, some boxes that had my mum's vinyl collection in and my late stepdad's vinyl collection in. I sort of uncovered it a few months ago and thought, oh yes, I'll raid that at some point. And today, she doesn't know it yet because she's out, but today I've decided to raid those. A lot of this stuff is sort of charity shop fodder, but there's some good stuff, some very good stuff. Which I'll show you at the start, but basically there are two boxes up there, one with mum's, one with my stepdad's. As you'll see, most of his stuff is jazz. There's a load of classical as well, but I haven't brought that down. Mum's, I probably took about half of it. The rest of it didn't really interest me. But yeah, without any more ado, this is what I found. We'll start with the gold. This is a... I have just been through on Discogs and checked the Beatles ones, because there's more than one Beatles album here. This is, as you can see, mono... I think this was a third pressing of Please Please Me. I think... Let me check. No, I can't check, because I'm recording on you. I think it was a third pressing. If not, I'll pop it on the screen. Cover is, I'd say, good... plus, and then the vinyl is probably again good, maybe to good plus, but there's quite a few light scratches on it. I don't think they'll affect play. I haven't cleaned them, you know, literally just brought all this down. I haven't cleaned them, haven't play tested. Then help again, mono. This is an first pressing and a variant of a first pressing. Was it the first pressing? It was first press. I'm trying to remember what it said. I think it was first pressing anyway. It has multiple variants and it's a specific variant. I'll pop them on the screen so for those of you who are interested. It's not ultra rare, but you know, it's a good £30 record. Vinyl on that one is very good, a very good plus. A sleeve, yeah, probably very good. Now the real gold. Mono, revolver, sleeve. Very good minus, probably. Original inner. And those magic words in the matrix. XEX 606 stroke 1. This is an original first mono pressing done on the first day of pressings with the alternate mix of Tomorrow Never Knows. The vinyl itself, probably very good minus. Probably about a £70 to £100 record there. Very nice. And finally on the Beatles, Sgt. Pepper. I think this was a fifth pressing. Again, mono. Unfortunately, it hasn't got the cutouts sheet. Has got the original inner though. And again, some light, you can see a scratch there. Can't feel it, so hopefully it won't affect play, apart from maybe a bit of noise. But yeah, that, you know, I knew there was Beatles up there. I was pretty certain we had that revolver and it was that pressing, but it was nice to double check and confirm. I thought she had a bit more Beatles, but they must have been my dad's, which he took with him when he left. And I don't think he's got any more. I think he got rid of all his vinyl for swine. Okay, so the bulk of the rest of it, I haven't been through the rest and checked if any of it's worth anything. I doubt it. It mostly seems charity shop fodder. But it's all stuff of some interest to me. This was just curiosity. Edward Woodward, This Man Alone. I have a stop press on it. On Sunday, March 8th, 1970, Edward Woodward received Britain's Society of Film and Television Arts Award as Television Actor of the Year for his role as Callan in the Thames television series Callan. Yeah. About this album, Edward Woodward does a little piece, Sir Bernard Miles, Sheila Hancock, and then Mike and Bernie Winters and Leslie Crowther. I mean, any of these, if it turns out that I don't like them, I'll just stick them back up in the loft. But if not, they'll go in the collection. This is on DJM. It seems pretty mint. Which means it probably won't play much, which means it might not be that good. But we shall see. Lionel Richie's self-titled album. Yeah, I think it is self-titled. This has got Truly on it, and My Love. Other ones that spring to mind. Original Anna on Motown. A couple of light marks, nothing major. A couple of Manfred Mann. We have the Five Faces of Manfred Mann. I do like Manfred Mann a lot. So these were no-brainers to grab. Again, with these, I don't know if any of them have got any value without checking. They look to be original. Well, you know, they definitely were bought at the time. This is mono copy. Again, I don't know if it's very first pressing or what have you, and if that means anything with these. Also, Man Made, again in mono. On HMV. Fingerprinty, but don't look too bad. Well, I'm just going to realise how long this is going to run, so I'm not going to spend quite as much time on each one. This one is sort of my sort of thing. This is Strings for Pleasure, Play Simon and Garfunkel. I collect sort of Beatles covers albums, and I just like them as background music, these sort of things. On Music for Pleasure, original in usual red MFP label. There was a copy of Parsley, Sage, Rosemary and Thyme up there, which would have saved me £10. Didn't have to buy that, never mind. This was actually mine and my sister's. So I bought it down. Welcome to Cambridge Green from Watch With Mother. Many listens to this as a kid. Again on MFP, the blue one. I'm actually considering. I was taking care of my records even back then by the looks of it. Can't see anything wrong with that really, apart from a little bit of dirt. This one, I've got a feeling, thinking about it, that Mum won in a competition from BBC Radio Solent. I might be wrong. This is Yes Minister. Original soundtracks from BBC TV series. The Devil You Know and Doing the Honours. For some reason, it's got a couple of staples through it. Not quite sure about that. It's got a PVC, polylined clear sleeve inside, which doesn't seem to want to come out. It's a hair. Yeah, it's just a hair. again, remember listening to that. Gene Pitney, I don't mind, so I'll grab this. Gene Pitney's Big 16. Sort of an early greatest hits. Again, mono. Originally in on the stateside. A couple of Hollies. This is just called The Hollies, so I'm guessing it's their debut, but I might be wrong. Again, in mono. The problem with a lot of these, like the Beatles, they didn't have the singles on the albums. Yeah, a couple of fingerprints, a couple of light scratches, nothing major. And would you believe The Hollies? Again, mono. Looks like the original inner. I mean, they all should be. Unless they, you know, they got badly damaged or something, but I can't see why they would have. This is really going to be long, isn't it? I'm going to... huge stack of Adam Faye for my mum. Adam Faye is her favourite. So I've grown a bit of an affection for him over the years. So this is Adam. This is a music pleasure release of it, actually. Mono, Adam Faith, arranged and conducted by John Barry. Oh, this is a gold Parlophone. Which, I don't know, you know, they all were back when this was released. It doesn't make it ultra valuable. Not like with Please Please Me. It's nice to see one. Faith Alive. With the Roulettes and Chris Andrews. For you, Adam. Again, all mono. From Adam with Love. Again, gold Parlophone. On the Move, Adam Faith. This is a later album on Warner Brothers, 1974. I Survive, it's called. It's got a lyric booklet thingy. Huh.
strange. Then we've got some Mamas and Papas. So we have Golden Era Volume 2. Which is... it's a compilation by the looks of it, but it's not really a hit. It's Dream a Little Dreams on here, but... it's on Stateside, as you can see. Otherwise... no, none of the big tracks. I mean, I have a Mamas and Papas compilation anyway. And then Papas and Mamas, the album. Dream a Little Dream of Me. On here again, no. That's the only one that's instantly leaping. Some RCA Victor. Also, Deliver. It's got Dedicated with One I Love, Creek Alley. Leap Out, apart from some covers as well. Original Inner on RCA Victor. Again, all mono. I'll get in. A couple of Frank Sinatra compilations. Greatest Hits of the Early Years. I have a CD box set of Frank Sinatra. Electronically Created Stereo. So that's just my mono double, didn't it? Nothing major on there, tracks wise. Frank Sinatra Greatest Hits Volume 2. That's more like it. Well, even then, it's got My Way on it. Got some covers of some good tracks. On Reprise. Also up there was a Melanie album that I have bought, so that's another £8 probably I could have saved. Me by Sandy Shaw. And Pie. Alison Moyet's Alf. An album I see all the time, but I knew it was up there, so I've never picked it up. Needs a clean, definitely. Any fingerprinty. Probably means I played it as a kid. And finally, from Mum's Box, Status Quo from the makers of. A collection of very best of Status Quo on two LPs with a classic selection of live tracks on a third LP. In my head, I remember this as being a live album, but obviously not. This I do remember, which is a set of these are in it. Flimsy 80s vinyl, which is really noticeable after all those 60s albums. Different type of sleeve for a third one. Very strange. else on here? Pictures of Matchstick Men, Ice in the Sun, Down with Dust Pipe, In My Chair, Junior's Wailing, Mean Girl, Gordon Doola, Paper Plane, Big Fat Mama, Roadhouse Blues, Paper Rules, Down Down, Bye Bye Johnny, Rain, Mystery Song, Blue For You, Is There A Better Way, Again and Again, Accident Prone, Wild Side of Life, Living on an Island, What You're Proposing, Lies, Rock and Roll, Something About Your Baby and Dear John, Been Live, We've Got Caroline, Roll Over, Lay Down, Backwater, Little Lady, Don't Drive My Car, Whatever You Want, Hold You Back, Walking All Over the World, Over the Edge, and Don't Waste My Time. So, the live, none of the live versions have got the studio versions on here. So that was, yeah, what I grabbed from Mum's box. I don't think I left anything up there that I'm going to want. Then in Pete's box, my late stepfather, as I say, it was mainly jazz and classical, apart from a sort of soundtracky one, which we'll get to. I didn't bring any of the classical down, but then right at the end, there's an anomaly. First up, we have the legendary Glenn Miller, Volume 4. I've brought most of the jazz down, if not all of it. Because, you know, I do like jazz, although his taste in jazz was largely trad. Which I do like, but I prefer the more experimental, you know, bebop onwards stuff. Also, Volume 5. This isn't jazz, but it's easy. Yeah, there's some easy listening stuff as well. Carpenter's Live at the Palladium. I have two Carpenter's greatest hits, so it's a nice compliment to them on A&M. It was naughty though. Did initial the records. Not all of them by the looks of it, thankfully. Sinatra of the Early Years. I just don't think it's the same track listing as on the other Sinatra one. No. It's not. So yeah. Brought that down as well. A Windmill. Best of Louis Armstrong, The Early Years. Can't go wrong with a bit of Louis. Dixieland Jazz for Storyville Stompers. Again, Spectro Stereo Dimension. Again on Windmill. This one, I mean, just the cover and title isn't enough. It's Ken Collier's Jazzmen with Watch That Dirty Tone of Yours, There Are Ladies Present. On Joy Records. Again, I think it's sort of New Orleans, Dixieland type jazz. That's just a magnificent cover. A collection of Scott Joplin rags. I like a bit of Scott. Again on Windmill, they must have been possibly a budget label, but certainly one that specialised in jazz and the like. I might be wrong, but he seems to have a lot on there. George Gershwin, Rhapsody in Blue and American in Paris, Michael Legrand and his orchestra. I do like a bit of Gershwin. This is on Contour. All That Jazz, Fats Waller, double album, I think. Yes, double album. On DJM. Big Spiderbeck, Giants of Jazz series. Ooh, I'm showing you that, and you can't see the label on that side. The Best of Old Blue Eyes. Yeah, again. On Reprise, a Sinatra compilation with very few actual hits on there. Got You Under My Skin, Witchcraft, Fly Me to the Moon, not too bad. More Louis Armstrong, Immortal Sessions. Again on Windmill. Soundtrack to 2001 A Space Odyssey. Original. And on MGM. Very nice label. Spitfire flying overhead. I don't know if you can hear that. I think it's the last weekend it's here before it goes away for the winter. A couple of Shirley Bassey, wonderful Shirley Bassey with Jeff Love and his orchestra. Some Music for Pleasure. Can't go wrong with a bit of Shirl. Thoughts of Love, which looks like a normal album rather than a live or a comp or anything. And United Artists. And then, so Pete really didn't like modern music. You know, jazz and classical was his collection basically. There was one modern artist who he liked up until a point, and that was Rolling Stones, and that point was basically up until his compilation. So yeah, this is Roll Gold, the very best of the Rolling Stones, which I do have on CD. I have a couple of Stones compilations of the Big Hits and Green Grass pair I picked up a few record store days ago, but yeah, couldn't leave this up in the loft. It's about the only one of his records that I used to play. Used to borrow it from time to time. But yeah, that is it. As I say, don't think there's anything else in those two boxes. I'll bring down maybe the classical stuff eventually. Well, that's going to be, you know, long-term future when I have a full music room and I can have a classical section. There is another box up there of Pete's, which has got some more jazz stuff and a few other bits in there. And a couple of there's an Adam Faith in there that I think was Pete's. I think it's one that is a duplicate of one of those. Load of 78s in that one, which I'm not sure. I know my record player will play at 78 RPM, but I know in the old days you used to have a special needle to play the 78s. I don't know if that's still the case. If anybody knows and would like to tell me. Well, I thought it was a dead spider for a minute and I was trying to be incredibly brave, but it was a bit of cotton anyway. Yeah, so if anybody knows whether old, you know, big thick 78s from the 50s or what have you, I can just play them on my turntable without needing to do anything other than setting it at 78 RPM. I would be very grateful. But yeah, hope you found that interesting. Thank you for watching. Like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Thanks. Bye.